Hello, Facebook, YouTube. The day of Raphael, not Tuesday. All right, congrats, Ohio State Buckeyes. Because of Urban Meyer, my favorite coach, y'all won the game. You know, I like Urban Meyer. You know, he's one of my favorite coach. But because of Urban Meyer, you won the game, Buckeyes. All right, okay, just want to get that out of the way. Thing is, you know, how y'all doing? All right, have a blessed day. Thing is, you know, people just, you know, we live we're in the end times, guys. We're in the period of the end times that people, if they, you know, aware of the idea, you know, of how God is orchestrating everything, they will know that we're in the end times. And in the end times, you're supposed to, you know, find out what's going on. Well, the spirit of the Lord will reveal to you what's going on, you know, and you just have to recognize that idea, what's going on, and understand that you must respond. Those must respond, you know what I'm saying? Not everybody. Those, if it's you, it's time to respond, you know? And the thing is, you know, people are not really understanding that it is the end time. The end time is here, according to the blood tetra, you know, the blood tetra, this and how it's operated, you know what I'm saying, that a solar eclipse is coming, you know what I'm saying, it's maybe like this, the year of Jubilee should be this year, you know what I'm saying, that people don't know, because I bet they don't follow, you know, the signs of the heavens correctly, because Jesus said they won't follow it, you know what I'm saying? In Matthew 16, you know, they, you know, if the sky was red, you know, they still won't know what's really going on, you know what I'm saying? If the whole sky turned red, you know, if God made this whole sky turn red, people still will be doing what they want to do. People still will be so caught up in this world system and say, oh, wait a minute, I need to get my life together. You will think these blood moons will be, you know, hey, on Jewish holidays. You know, not in any other day, you know, just put them out there. Like, what if they have blood moons just on two blood moons on 1 year? That's a typical. But when you have two blood moons exactly in the beginning of two Jewish holidays, you know, alert. No urgency for people, just as Jesus and Paul says, you know, it won't be urgent. You know, they, you know, like they wax cold, you know. It's, you know, it's a cold world, and the world is getting colder, and I hope that you're not getting colder with it, you know. And, of course, the church is getting lukewarmy, you know. Just a little hot, you know. Not, you know, blazing, not trying to blaze, but just a little hot, you know, is crazy. I tell people to check your spiritual temperature. I mean, the thing is, it is easy. Your performance should tell your temperature. You know what I'm saying? But what you're doing concerning the things of God, are you fellowshipping? That's all I'm saying. Are you trying to fellowship with, you know, believers on a daily basis? You know what I'm saying? That's going to really be the, if you really, you know, all about burning up, you know, burning hot like fire, you know what I'm saying? So you can be tried by fire and become pure as gold. That's the whole idea what Jesus is trying to say in, you know, Revelations 3. You know what I'm saying? You gotta get hot. You know what I'm saying? It's time to get hot. It's time to, like, you know, my boy on Fantastic Four, you know, flame on. It's flaming time, you know. This ain't cold time, you know. You know, here's the thing that, you know, the deception of, you know, people, here's what number one deception I see Satan got on people. People have the mundane, you know, mindset that, you know, it's just another day. It's just another, you know, this day, just like the other day. No, this is a new day. If you look, if you're living in the newness of Christ, you will know that each and every day is a new day. And you will approach it like it's a new day. Understand that you are approaching to a season concerning the things of God. The things of God, not the things of, you know, men. You know men's season, you know. But the things of God, and only by the Spirit you can detect and discern this time, you know. And it's sad how people are just, you know, oh man, it's sad, you know. But God said it, and Jesus and everybody said it's going to be like this. It's sad. But going to the topic of my message, yes, I do got a topic of the message. You know, it's called the reality of, you know, responding spiritually. The reality of responding spiritually. Just kind of like the discussion I just came up with. You know, it's just, here's the thing, you know, it's just simple. The kingdom of God is not meat or drink, but is righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. May I repeat for my atheist friends, the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, natural, temporal, but is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. You know what I'm saying? Spiritual things, you know? And, you know, because my atheist friends, you know, they don't like spiritual things. They don't like faith. And they think faith is bad and whatever from their, you know, carnal standpoint. I have to kind of talk to them a little bit. But the thing is, look, if we Christians are about the kingdom of God, the response supposed to be about is to learning how to become righteous. And, you know, and it says in, read Romans 10. Romans 10 is, oh, you know, that's where, you know, the salvation scripture, you know, I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart. But read the, Romans 10 and 3, you know, it talks about the differentiating, you know, God's righteousness. We got to learn the righteousness of God and not our own righteousness. You know what I'm saying? You know, the response ability, you know, but you know, you need to learn to develop a response. You know what I'm saying? Because nobody really not responding to urgency of really, you know, trying to fellowship. I'm telling you, just fellowship is the agenda. Fellowship is the agenda. Call people, whatever, you know, be with people, set a time of talking about the things of God to get, start talking, your convert, like I did a conversations, and very important, you know, it's, this is what the hour, this is the hour that the main thing you need to do is fellowship with believers as much as you can during your day. You know what I'm saying? If you got believers at work, you got believers at school, you need to find time to share and talk about the things of God. That's what I'm kind of, that is really the emergency thing to do right now. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, when you start responding that way, then you start getting, understanding what a spiritual plan, God's divine plan, is being implemented and seeing what it's all about. You know what I'm saying? You will start engaging in spiritual activity more. You know, you start leaning towards doing the things of God more. You will see, it will come about. But you just need to do this one thing. And that is fellowship, you know what I'm saying? And share the word of God concerning, you know, the things of God. That's the urgency right now. You know what I'm saying? And guess what? Anybody can do this. Sinners can do this. Sinners can say, you know, hey, you know, I need to start, you know, fellow, find somebody to just share, talk about the word of God, you know what I'm saying? On a daily basis, as much as possible, you know, from where I'm at. You know, you can call somebody, you know, you can go hang out with somebody. Let's say, hey, let's talk about this. You know what I'm saying? You know, look, the thing is, I have, you know, Mac Johnson on YouTube, you know what I'm saying? Or, you know, Facebook. I mean, you can talk about some of my videos, what I talk about concerning righteousness, you know, and ask questions about it amongst each other and say, what do you think about this? What do you think about that? You know what I'm saying? And from your perspective, you know, and that's how really simple fellowship can, you know, go about, you know, just understanding the perspective and keep, you know, seeing how this saying is and seeing how this saying that and what your view and, you know, and pray. And then pray at the end of it to say, Lord, give us the revelation to know your truth and how to operate in your righteousness. And you will get the answer. You know what I'm saying? You will know how to respond spiritually when you need to respond concerning the time. I mean, you know, you respond spiritually. It's simple. Finding other people to join in your fellowship, you know what I'm saying? Finding other people, hey, we're finna talk about God. We're finna talk about this. That's it. We're finna talk about God. We're finna talk about God's word, you know, for a little while. You can come join us. That's the only simple response you can do right now. I mean, that's the kingdom. And I'm talking about, this is the kingdom response, you know what I'm saying? This ain't church no more. This ain't, you know, the idea is just go in the building on Sunday and hear the word of God and just, you know, go out and really just go out and really do nothing. You know what I'm saying? This ain't that. This is more likely start fellowshipping amongst your brothers and sisters around you as much as possible. Come in the understanding, I mean, of the truth by sharing God's word, you know, just sharing God's word. You know what I'm saying? Guess what? You're not going to start performing and living God's word, you know what I'm saying, automatically. But as much as you continue doing it and come in agreement with God's word, the motivation of you to respond to do something spiritual and do something like God will occur. But you just have to keep fellowshipping the word of God. You got to keep and stay faithful and disciplined at fellowshipping the word of God. I mean, yes, you're going to say negative things or maybe do negative things. But as faithful as you are sharing the word of God, like the woman that was at the well, she slept with, you know, five people, you know, is she went out and shared the word of God. Come see a man that know everything of me, even though she, you know, is part of a Babylonian, I mean, of a Sumerian system, you know, worshiping other gods, did not stop him from performing spiritually. And she's performing spiritually, and she, you know, probably labor as an adulterer. But yet she performed spiritually, knowing that, you know, she fooled around, but still spread out that she met the man Jesus Christ anyway. So look, there's no excuses really to not share the word of God if you follow the word of God concerning, you know, the Bible, you know what I'm saying? Stop the religious part. You know, people, you know, I hear sinners say, well, you know, I don't want nobody judging me. What? Judging you? What do you mean judging you? You know what I'm saying? See, it's like they're thinking of the religious people that wanted to stone a woman that's caught in adultery. You know what I'm saying? We are serving Jesus Christ, the one that, you know, forgave the woman that was in adultery, you know, caught in adultery, you know, and said, go forth and sin no more. That's Jesus Christ. You know what I'm saying? Jesus, it's not about sinning. It's all about talking about the word of God and fellowship. And I pray that you start responding spiritually when you understand that it's just sharing God's word. It's period, point blank, on a daily basis. That's what Jesus desired you to do. You know what I'm saying? Not that you gonna minister or preach to nobody, but just keep sharing and talking about God's word amongst a lot of people and get more understanding of it. And that's the message. So I hope this encourages you to respond spiritually and, you know, start doing the will of God. All right, to God be the glory, here and forever and ever. Here in Jesus' name, amen.